9, 10 years ago.
Wow. I was at Limore and
Tell everybody the story, how you ended up fighting Josesito Lopez in his third pro fight. You weighed like 180, he weighed like 130. Okay, sorry, 160.
The day of the weigh-in or the day before?
We showed up for a fight with another fighter. Yes. And, his opponent never showed up, so.
You weighed 130.
Yeah, actually, that was the lightest I've ever weighed. I was like 128.
His third pro fight.
130.
What did you weigh?
I weighed in right before I walked into the ring.
Okay.
Not lying. I signed a contract and waited right before I
signed. But how'd you make weight if you were 160 the day before?
Can't tell you.
What do you think happened? You think somebody else went on the scale?
I don't know how it happened, but...
What do you think happened, Matt? How did your dad make weight? Do you think... Okay, these are the options. Somebody else weighed. You had only 1 foot on.
I had 1 foot on, stepped in, stepped out. I had one glove on, and I took the other glove to sign the contract. So they weighed me in, and I stepped in, stepped out. 138.
That's amazing. How are people going to do that? And then what happened in the fight itself? Did you win?
I think I won one round. No, it was four rounds.
Yeah.
But you know, of course, his coach was looking at me like, this fucker doesn't weigh 130.
You probably weighed 160.
I remember him.
I didn't train.
I just showed up to. We had a fighter on that card.
But that's an amazing story. Now he's a coach with a record of 94 wins and one loss. That's his record as a coach. And you have been. Josesito's supposed to fight. What's his name? Keith Thurman, maybe. What do you think about that fight?
That's a good fight. I want Keith Thurman. You know, he's up there. He was considered the number one welterweight.
He's undefeated.
Undefeated at one point. So now I think I think Errol Spence took his spot, but that's because of his inactivity. So that's a good fight. I think he's still the champion, considered a WBA super champion or something.
Okay.
Like that.
How about this? Pacquiao, Broner. Who you got? You know Broner. You know Pacquiao.
Depends on what Broner shows up. I mean, that's everybody's. Broner's skilled, talented, but at 147, I don't know if it's got a. He can carry that up there with Pacquiao.
Josesito?
Yeah, man. Pacquiao's still tough, man. Pacquiao's still got it, so it's going to be a tough fight for Broner. You know, how tough, it depends on what Broner comes with, you know, but it's going to be a good one.
Okay, Fury, Wilder.
I give it to Wilder. Wilder, you know, Fury's inactivity and all his. Out of the ring activities.
How cool is that? That I never met him and he got mad when he saw me.
What did he say? He knew your name?
Yeah.
He said, Ellie, get out.
That's pretty cool. Thanks for making me famous.
Yep.
What do you think, Wilder Fury?
I like Wilder. I think it'll be a good competitive fight. But I think it gets a little tough for Wilder if he doesn't get him out in the first 5-6 rounds. I think it gets a little tough on him, but. I think he's still pulls it off though.
Okay, and then the last one I'm gonna ask you guys about, Mikey Garcia Spence. You know Mikey, you know Errol?
That's a gutsy move by Mikey. Move up there to fight the number one welterweight right now. It's, in my opinion, it's Errol Spence. And he's a good fighter. Lefty, top of it. So I don't know. It's a tough fight for Mikey, but we're with Mikey.
Mikey's a badass, man. He's the best at 135, 140, and he wants to test the waters at 147 against the best. Size is a little bit of a difference, but with his skill, man, if there's anybody that can come up weight divisions and win a big fight, it's definitely Mikey, man. I'm choosing Mikey.
What would it take for you to have a rematch with Marco?
Cut my leg off to make weight again.
Alright, there you have one leg on the scale. Stay tuned. Tell me where to follow you.
Jose Lopez on Instagram, man.
MacBoxer19 on Instagram.
MacBoxer19. Stay tuned. BusinessReport.com. I'm Elie Seckbach recording. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach. Thank you. That was good.